If we go back, all the way back to 1500 years ago, when we reinvented a new way of recording transactions, and if we see the impact that had and still has on our current day society, and we now actually have another new invention of recording transactions, we are on the very brink of reinventing society of the future. That might last another 1500 years. So imagine the effort it took me when I received the question, can you think of some use cases? Well, many, many use cases, of course. But also mentioned before, it is very important that you realize that we are on the very brink and that it needs to prove itself. So these are potential use cases. So this is basically asking somebody 1500 years ago, so you now have double entry bookkeeping, what do you think the future will look like? So they most likely didn't think of our current day society, right? So what we're going to do here is we're going to give you some use cases, but these are the use cases based on current society and reforming current society into this new model. Most likely we will think of way new forms of society that still need to be thought of. Who imagined that you could create or that you could actually send airplanes across the other side of the world by using the internet in the beginning early of the 90s. So who can create new forms of decentralized organizations? Who know what forms they will take? Who knows? I picked two an overview of different use cases. You see many different use cases. Important to realize here, once mentioned before, I'll mention it again, is that this is in the very beginning stage. So don't get all your hopes up and try to experiment, do get your hopes up and experiment, but don't bet all your money or your entire organization that it's going live within 1 or 2 years. That doesn't mean that there are applications are already live. There are some very interesting stuff happening already, but on a global scale, mass adoption will most likely take a few years. Important is that we're reinventing governance. And by reinventing governance, we have, for example, impact in financial section, in integrity verification, of course, digital timestamping, and think about self-sovereign identities, stuff like that. Very, very interesting stuff. We need to set the fundamental pillars for the next economy in a straight line, and then we're going to create new use cases. So examples of use cases I always like are a decentralized internet. Well, before giving some things away, you've got the Augur token. I like, for example, the Augur token, where you actually have a prediction platform where you can basically estimate upon the masses, or you can predict the future based upon the estimation of a very big group of people. So if you ask one people how many kilograms a hippo weighs, you have all different kinds of estimation. But if you ask 10,000 people what a hippo weighs, the median, the average estimation of all these people probably is very near the truth. So the extremes weigh each other out, and this is known as the power of the big numbers, the power of the masses. And if you use this in prediction concepts, like for example, who's going to be the next president, who will win this soccer game, what's the weather going to be like tomorrow, or also very interesting, what's the price of this financial derivative, or the price of Bitcoin going to be, or the price of gold, gives of course tremendous amounts of value. And basically perhaps a very good scope of, or a better scope, or better indication of the future. So that's why I like Augur. Also the technical use case and the use case of the dual token, which we will explain later on. Another good example is the Brave browser, which we will show you later on. Basically, it's a browser just like Google, like Firefox, like Chrome or Firefox. Only this time, they blocked all the commercials, and you can actually integrate it with a wallet where you can start earning money based on your surf behavior. And you can actually tip other content creators when you see a good comment on Twitter, or when you see a good Medium post, or when you see a good Steemit post. So basically you earn money with surfing. That money is currently held by your other browser provider, for example, Google, if you use Google Chrome. And this time, it's your data, so it's your money, it's your value, and you can pass it along to whomever you want. Also a very fun one is Pixel Masters, where people can get rewarded for art, so you can create some strange picture. I always like the concept, what was the very first thing people started creating when they start, when you ask people to create something on a decentralized digital public ledger, and they can draw something based on a smart contract, and they get rewarded for their art. What was the very first thing people started to draw? They started to draw dicks, and they started to draw names. So it doesn't matter what the medium is, it's still human technology. So in this case, very interesting, we will copy paste the link in the slides, check it out, and you can use, of course, very cool market mechanism. Do important realize is next session, I won't disclose what we're going to do there. You will see when you click on next button. See you there.